growing up, I was always around the game of basketball. My father is the director of an AAU basketball program, and I would always go on the trips with them, and I would follow around the guys. They were like my older brothers, and I would see them, you know, do certain moves in games, and I would try to go mimic those moves at recess or wherever I was playing. I first learned my passion for the game probably around 2 or 3 years old. I always had like a little tight basketball hoop in the house. I was asking for basketball stuff just about every single Christmas. Every chance I got to play, I always played. And to start off, I was only playing in the local leagues, you know, in my town growing up. Then my father introduced me to the AAU team. He started a team for me. I saw that there was so much more talent out there, and the game could bring me to so many places. And it was more than just about the actual game in and of itself, which I already had tremendous love for. I've been blessed enough to have a lot of great coaches who taught me how to play the game the right way through New York Lightning, and then through my high school coaches at Lawrence Wilmere Academy and Blair Academy. And I was fortunate enough to be able to play Division I basketball at the University of Pennsylvania. And I had a great time there. I made a lot of good connections. And ultimately, I just had to make a decision that it was time for a change. And St. John's seemed to be the right place. I think the prospect of being back home closer to my family, being able to play several games at Madison Square Garden, a chance to rebuild New York's, you know, premier basketball school to its glory days, and then you know, they have a Hall of Fame coach. That didn't hurt at all. I was never around or alive, you know, during the times when New York teams were winning championships, at least in basketball. But I think that it would be a huge impact on the city, and I think that it would be great for more kids in New York, you know, wanting to stay in New York. I still think that it is the mecca of basketball, and if we could bring, you know, a national championship to New York at St. John's, then we'll see a lot of that talent go from high schools in New York to coming here, hopefully. Where I'm from, don't know any professionals that I've seen on TV, but I'm sure it would be a huge inspiration, you know, just to see somebody who went to the same school as me, grew up in the same neighborhood as me, played in the same parks as me, was able to make it there. I think that a lot of kids would stop limiting themselves in what they see their potential to be. So my favorite players growing up were Isaiah Thomas of the Bad Boy Pistons, Rajon Rondo, and Carmelo Anthony. I think that basketball is an art form, and I think that everybody plays it the way that they're meant to, and everybody expresses their art in different ways. I don't base myself off trying to emulate anybody else's game, because somebody, I don't know who it was, but somebody said comparison is the thief of all joy, and I think it was very true. Outside of just God blessing me with all that he's given me, it has been my two parents. They've sacrificed a lot for me to be where I am. They've never hesitated to do what was best for me. Without them, I wouldn't be able to do anything that I do. I don't even know if Coach P knows this, but I actually have a cousin who was on his, you know, favorite 1996 Kentucky team, Allen Edwards, that won the national championship. So there's a lot of basketball pedigree in my family, and I haven't come anywhere near what a lot of my cousins and my father and my uncle have done. So, you know, a lot of humility, but also a lot of love and care, and, you know, they taught me the basis of the game. So I owe them, you know, everything. I've been having a lot of fun. You know, I try to treat myself like a sponge as much as possible and just soak up all the knowledge. I'm one of the older guys on the team. You know, we make jokes about it all the time. I've been playing college basketball for a while, but I treat it as if I'm a 16-year-old kid. I pay attention to everything that he says in great detail. I'm always asking questions, and I'm always trying to learn how to improve more. And when you have somebody who has as much knowledge and experience as he has, then it's kind of like a kid in a candy shop. You know, when you like to ask questions, you like to learn. My goals beyond St. John's are really just to be as good of a person as I can be. I've been blessed to experience all that I've experienced, and my parents have done a lot for me. God has given me everything, and I want to continue to impact people's lives in a positive way.